Today we will see what does your hometown look like. And I welcome you to the question answer channel. The channel where you will find the answer to everything. Today the answers will be presented by Ratnakar Sadasyula, Srilatha Padmanavan, Abhishek Trail and Varan. We will start with the first answer of Ratnakar Sadasyula.
My hometown is Visakhapatnam aka Vizag, and the most beautiful thing about it is that you have the hills on one side and the sea on another side, giving it this lovely look. And the best thing is that these sites are within the city, need not travel too far out either. It has Kailasagiri where you can go to the top and get a view of the city like this. And the night view is even better. You can travel all the way up to Kailasagiri via ropeway, have this large statue of Shiva and Parvati there. You have the Dolphin's Nose, basically a large hill getting its name from the shape. It forms the entrance to Vizag Port, and is one of the city's iconic landmarks. And you get an equally awesome view of the city and Bay of Bengal from there. Want to relax in the evenings? You have the RK Beach, where you can hang out, watch some concert or dance show, choose from the umpteen food and drink stalls, or just laze around. And the beach road itself has a whole lot of sights to see. An excellent Kali Mata Mandir, in typical Bengali style. One of the more prominent Ramakrishna Maths Submarine Museum, only one of its kind in India. Aircraft Museum, not to mention beautiful parks like VUDA Park Tenneti Park with an awesome view of the Bay of Bengal. VUDA City Central Park, this was actually the old prison area in the city, that was shifted out later. Now a magical wonderland at night, with awesome fountains. And no, Vizag is not just fun and frolic, it is one of the 13 major ports in India, second largest in terms of cargo handled. And this port is a vital point of export for the mines in southern Odisha, Chattisgarh and northeastern part of Andhra Pradesh. It is also the HQ of the Eastern Naval Command, making it strategically important. The city was one of the main targets for Pakistan during the 1971 war. Vizag is also one of the major industrial centers in India, with a whole lot of PSU giants located here. The Vizag Steel Plant, built with German-Soviet collaboration, one of the major integrated steel plants in India. HPCL Refinery. Hindustan Shipyard Limited. Hindustan Zinc, now part of Vedanta Group BHEL. And finally, one image that sums up my hometown. The church on Ross Hill, the Venkateswara Temple on another hillock, and the Dargah near Kotaveedhi, all existing from long time. Three different faiths in total harmony, which symbolizes my hometown. One of the few places in India unaffected by communal riots and which a large number of people from all corners of India have made their home.
The next answer is from Srilatha Padmanavan.
I come from Coimbatore, a city in Tamil Nadu, India. My hometown is famous for textile mills, called as Manchester of South India, and its climate. Marudumalai Murugan Temple, Isha, Siravani Waterfalls, world's tastiest water smiley face, entrapped with hill stations in three sides, and source of employment to thousands of people because of its vast scope of small-scale industries. Authentic cuisine, G.D. Naidu Car Museum. Finally, smiley face.
What do you think? We will continue with Abhishek Tree's answer.
I hail from a little village in Coorg, Karnataka. I grew up in Bangalore and Chennai, but 2 months of every year was always sincerely dedicated to my grandma back at home. It wasn't just eat and sleep. Fishing, taking the cows to the grassland, an afternoon swim at the river, working late evening at the farm, honey hunting in the forest, desi cricket, chasing the roosters, climbing trees for orange, guava and jackfruit, stargazing, treks, howling like wolves for no reason, well, I could go on and on. Things have changed, I've grown up, traveled places, and now, work doesn't let me go there often. Damn, I miss home a lot. I'll let the pictures do the talking. See those tiny roofs? That's our beautiful hamlet downhill. Yay, every day is trek day. The surreal waterfalls, a 10-minute drive, our evergreen farm, and a bit of coffee estate. And when I'm in a mood to go on a tiny few hours casual trek, this is where one land. Did I not tell you about my pets? A 15-year-old country dog, a dozen pigeons, a few egg-laying ducks and yay, those irritating roosters. The ancestral house and the village temple. The river that feeds our farm, taught me to swim, and my place of solitude every time I go home. Plus, driving from town to my village through the forest in a deserted roadway, that's what orgasm feels like. Image source, my gallery. For the ones who've already visited the tourist spots in Coorg, let me tell you something, the hidden beauties of my hometown is manifold, and what you've seen there is just like brushing against a gold bar. The mine is way deep inside and will leave you in a trance once you start living there. I'll see you again, until then, sayonara.
We continue with Varun's answer.
Well, hello everyone. I am a resident of a very famous state of India. Any wild guesses? Yes, I think you're probably right. Bihar, where people think the infrastructure is something like this. But, to be honest, I've never seen such a situation in the past 10 years. Before that, of course I have. We all have. But majority of the days I've lived here, this is what I've witnessed. Well, this is where I live. My city, Darbhanga, roads like this. We have a university too, which used to be a fort by the way. Cheeky smiley face. the dirtiest railway station in India. But sometimes, you need to fall before you can get going. Believe me when I say, there are more than 200 ponds in the city itself. Though we have land sharks too, like most of the country. Damn them, we take good care of our deities and nature. Anyone who has ever been to Darbhanga recognizes this place in a heartbeat. The only Kali temple built on a shamshan, cremation ground, of the famed ruler of Darbhanga. Speaking of whom, we have the Darbhanga Palace. Last rebuilt in the 1930s after the earthquake, its walls are even higher than that of the Red Fort, Delhi. Sadly, neglected by authorities. Did I mention we have a Darbhanga Ghat in Varanasi as well? Well, I've kinda grown up hearing of all this rich heritage. And I'm amused when people who've never visited and stayed here form opinions about it. Anyways, every coin does have two faces. Here are some of my clicks. Hope you like them. En route my village. Sunset at my favorite place. Home. That's all from my side. Thank you for stopping by. Ciao. Image credits. Google and my own phone. Edit. 200 plus upvotes for the first time. Thank you everyone. Edit 2. This is surreal. More than 650 upvotes. Thanks a lot. Here is today's sunset at my home. Courtesy my phone. Ciao. Edit 3. This is absolutely amazing. 1,000 upvotes. Thank you everyone. One's home is always a good luck charm for them, I guess. Colon closing parenthesis.
This is the end of the video. Thank you for staying until the end. You can now subscribe if you like the video more. Remember to also leave a like, it helps for the referencing on YouTube. The video is over. You can continue discussing this question in the comments or find another question that interests you. See you next time.